I like to be a bald eagle.
Why?
Just because the bald eagle, they have such a free life, and to feel this adrenaline and the control of your body flying, you know, being able to see your food from a mile away in the sky, and like a predator, you know, the human is the most powerful predator, but we lack this control that an eagle have or another animal. So, bald eagle.
I would choose to be my father. And the reason why I would choose to be my father is because I would right some of the wrongs that he had to deal with, and I would probably live some dreams that he wanted to live, you know, and be probably the best father that he probably could have been. So if I could be someone for a day that wasn't living anymore and be the way and knowledgeable as I am now, it would be my father.
I would choose me, because I don't want to be nobody else. I'm really happy with who I am. You know who I would want to be?
Go on.
I would want to be See, it's a hard question. Maybe like a superhero or some shit, like one of the X-Men or some shit like that. But
why?
Because I like having powers and shit, you know what I mean? But seriously, I don't know. I've never thought about a question like that, because I'm so happy with who I am as a human being that, yeah, never came up. Nobody.
I don't really know how to answer this. My mind. My mind. I can't even go into the details about it. It's very strange.
Strangest place I ever had sex. It wasn't very strange, though, but it was on a balcony that was very high in a hotel. It was beautiful, though. You know, it was a beautiful moment, so it wasn't strange. You know what I mean? But it was crazy. Up way high, man. See nothing but clouds and birds. And then I was getting it in.
The strangest place? Is there a list from 1 to 10? I don't. behind the hotel in Sweden, on the ground and shit.
Human beings have free will. It's what separates us from animals, like lions and tigers and bears. They live the life off of instinct. They do have a will to do things, but the will is not something that they really impose. They act out off of their natural instincts. And people are more will-driven, even though we have instincts, but we have our will that can stop our instincts.
Do human beings have free will? Of course you have free will, you know. As long as you're motivated by God, you know, and you pursue what you should pursue, control what you can control, you know, and just kind of flow out here, man. Yeah, of course I believe that you have free will, you know.
Of course human beings have free will, but at the same time, be part of the collective. And your will is shaped by all the things around you. But yeah, I would say so. Yeah.
Love, fear, or music? Fear. I think fear has more power, in the sense that often we don't do things because of fear that we might be better people, because of fear of failure, fear of what another would think, fear of just the work or the things you have to do to make something happen sometime. And to me, fear is the one thing that keeps us all from like this utopia they speak about, that we can live on the planet together as one race, as humans, and we are all brothers. It's because of fear why this is not a reality. We fear each other. We fear, you know, we are jealous, and we're taught fear from babies, from childhood, and, you know. So fear, I think, is more powerful.
Okay. I think music has more power. Music has more power because music is the theme of life. Music is what everything evolves around, whether it's fear. There's fear music. Whether it's love, there's love music. Whether it's just music, everyday music. So I would say that music will always have the most power because it's the theme of life. That's basically it, bro.
Fear. Because, fear is the most powerful motivator. You know what I mean? I mean, music is powerful, but if you say to somebody, don't do something, or else I'll take away your music or whatever, that's still a fear, right? But if you tell a motherfucker, if you don't do this, you're gonna die, or, you know? So fear is the greatest motivator. Fear has the most power.
My weaknesses are definitely procrastination, not doing the things when I should do them, not having more order, more organization in my life. These are weaknesses. Sometimes self-control, not being able to control the self. Maybe I put myself in a dangerous situation, or I make myself unhealthy, or recklessness, kind of like most people's, especially like in the hip hop life and the type of being a one man show. And I manage myself and I push my career and I'm also writing lyrics, and you know, I have a lot of things to think about, and sometimes it's easy to get lost.
I have no weaknesses because a man that's weak is not a man. If something is pressure, if something if there's an adverse moment or something like that, you just have to be able to prepare and deal with the pressure. I don't believe that you should be weak. You know, wisdom grows strength. Life grows strength, you know, and experiences. So, you know, like me, I have no weaknesses. And I don't think death is a weakness because that's the inevitable in life, in the physical. So, you know what I mean? I don't have any weaknesses, man.
I'm not going to tell my weaknesses. Superman doesn't say kryptonite could kill me. You know what I mean? That's not happening.
Him being the president, does he directly feel the pressure from people outside of government who control America? Does he physically feel the pressure? Or is he just do his job and the pressure is set up that he has no connection with them, you know?
What are your picks on the NCAA tournament? Now, there's no special questions asked Obama because I feel that he's been monumental. His years in office have been productive, and like every other president, people will always have something to say about him, but me personally, I wouldn't have any questions for him. Maybe the question would be like, could I come to the White House with my wife and my fam and, you know, can we eat some good food? You know what I mean? So it would be nothing about the world because the United States, the function is what it is. You know, he's the commanding chief and the function is such. And I don't have any directions or any questions I'd like to ask him besides personal as far as Can we come to the White House? Can we eat some good food? Chill, you know? And if you play PlayStation, then can we play some PlayStation? You know what I mean? That's all I would really ask him. I'm real with that, you know what I mean?
Does Michelle have good pussy now?
No, I mean, this is a tricky question. Some parts yes, some parts no. The business side of it, of course, there is a big business side of hip hop. You know, this is how you look at that, how you take that. I try my best and do great business and do better business, work with good people, with good artists. For me as an artist to be touring with Gangsta Foundation and have the possibilities to work with, for instance, Bebsache or Cairo Hip Hop Heads or another guys in France or wherever, this is great. Hip hop is very dynamic. It's global. It's a huge universe. But what I don't like is that the hip hop and the culture, because there are so many other things that sometimes people, they don't even know what hip hop is, you know. It's a fashion, it's something that people are into now. There are not many people telling the story of the Crow Crush Brothers and Run DMC and, you know, the beginning stages of hip hop and, you know, nobody from the young generation. I mean, we do have new artists that they are developing new styles of hip hop, which are good, which are great. But I don't think nobody's really passing these messages that, like, for instance, I'm at my show and I see 16-year-old kids. A lot of times, those ones, they there because it's new, it's fresh, it's what's happening in the city. And this speaking about the culture of hip hop and the elements and how it's important to not lose any of them, I don't like. I don't like that some artist, just because he's rapping and his song is on the radio, people look at him or her like that's hip-hop, you know? Anybody can rap, doesn't make them hip-hop, you know? Rap is a way to rap, to sing, to share your idea. But hip-hop is when you involve the inspiration of what hip hop comes from, you know. You have many artists that maybe you don't like what they say, but they have this passion of, they have nothing and they get with their guy who's a producer or DJ and they sit in the studio or the basement or in the block and they make some creation from nothing. This is hip hop. Not everybody gonna say what you like, but the essence is what can take us to another place. And other people will use the formula for a different thing, you know? This part of the hip hop essence is, I think, the most important. The sharing with each other and what you do and how you do that and learning is, I think, the most valuable element in the hip-hop culture.
Yeah, man, I would say, because hip-hop is like an octagon, man, with different sides, you know? Or even a Rubik's Cube, if you're familiar with that, because it's always forever changing and remains complicated, but it also is basic. The reason why I say it's basic is because styles change, new styles come and go, but steady styles stay forever. You know, that's how we're out here all these years later doing tours and concerts, because hip hop is powerful in that way, and it's dimensional, it's multi-dimensional. So I like where it's at, because like I said, everybody brings something different, you know? You know, and the lower level of it is pretty saturated, you know, but that's just because, you know, it's a form of talk over music, rhythmic talking over music, some tend to think everyone can do it. So the lower it is on the totem pole, YouTubes or different apps or whatever, where people get their music out, SoundCloud, whatever, you'll hear some stuff that's not the most quality, but it's still hip hop because everybody's trying. So yeah, I'm cool with where hip hop is and where hip hop can go.
I mean, I like where hip hop is right now for JERU the Damaja, because I don't really, you know, follow it too much any other way, you know, because I'm in my own world. Like, I have a great movement going. So I stick with that movement. So yeah, because hip hop is worldwide. Look, I'm sitting here in Poland, you know, if it wasn't for where hip hop is today, I couldn't be here.
Yeah, I have a big passion that my number one passion in my life right now, besides music and my story as an artist and a man in music, is to be a good husband to my wife. You know, this is an everyday, not a challenge, but it is something that I have to work on, you know. And for all the people there who listen and see this that aren't married, or they have a girlfriend, or someday they think to marry, those people who have this magical relationship that it's easy and the love stay there and you stay excited and you stay funny and you stay creative and you stay in love, you know, I hope they can have that. But when you go through the emotions, you know, sometimes you can go to a mountain of sadness in a marriage, or depression, or you lose, or you can fight, or you can experience all about the relationship. Marriage is not every time, all the time, the best, you know. You have to go through the normality, and when you can still be in love with it so normal, or even not good, even bad, this is what it takes to stay married forever. And this is my number one passion beside my music and everything. And it's a challenge for me, you know, more than music. And because the music and business, I can do that, you know. This is something that, you know, it's not about emotions. It's not about you living for somebody else, you know? And that's the biggest pressure about the marriage, is that if I am there, whatever I do, I represent my wife too, in a way, you know? And that's what's up. It's your boy AFU-RA. You right here. Watch that. Peep that. Keep it locked right here. Watch out!
Now, my, you know, I'm music, man, part of me, in a big part. Like, you know, I sing as well as rap. So, you know, I have a project that I'm passionate about called The Living Room, which is a soul singing album that consists of all singing tracks by Big Shug, produced by the studio next door, guys out of South Africa. Headed in by this brother, Aminda Iyambo. Or it could be the other way, I'm bugging. But it's a great project. It's gonna be really, really good. Also, I'm passionate about being a parent and a family person. You know, so what I say is more passionate, I feel the balance is such, you know. You know where your passion should lie. You know it's the mechanisms of life, you know what I mean? So I wouldn't say there's something more passionate. I've been rhyming and singing this stuff for a long time, so it's just part of what I am, you know? So life itself is my passion, man. And as long as I continue to breathe and I'm able to bring music, I'm able to be a good person and productive man in this world, I'm peace, man. You know what I mean?
Yes, 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 yes. I'm also a photographer. I like film. I want writing movies and scripts. Yeah, that's it a lot. Film, anything that has to do with the camera and being creative, that's my passion. Yeah, I like to edit videos. I like to write scripts. That's why I was talking to the guys about it the other day. I have my own Black Magic camera. You know, that's makes me happy.